Australian boy's tinkering in his grandfather's garage has led to a global career in industrial design that brings us here to France and the world of Marc Newson. From furniture and objects to airplanes, interiors, and fashion, he's the man with the Midas touch of design and much, much more. I'm Amy Devers. This is Designer People, where we profile one leading designer through his or her creative connections.
It's very difficult to define myself. I mean, look, if I had to choose a definition, it would probably be industrial designer. I feel it's a very limiting definition for what I do because I do such a broad variety of things. My work in the aviation industry is purely industrial design. In fact, it really borders on engineering. But at the other end of the spectrum, I'm doing, inverted commas, exhibitions. And in that context, you can kind of do what you want. You can do it when you want, with the material that you want. It's all about your imagination and your desire to identify ways that you think you can improve things. You have to be a control freak to do a good job. You have to be in control because there are so many steps in the process from the inception of an idea to the realization of a product. It can take years. You've got to start to get the ideas out of your head. And I use a pen and paper. I've always had a sort of sketchbook every year, ever since I can remember. I try to take it, pretty much everywhere I go. In case I have an idea, then, and a sketchbook is not a way, I don't design with a sketchbook. It's simply a way to record an idea. It doesn't eradicate the need to build prototypes. Until you physically see something and you can physically touch something, you won't be completely happy with it. Before I was doing the furniture, I was making these weird sort of large objects that could be worn, but I think they're a bit like a kind of walking stick with a wheel on the end. You kind of had to push them around. Bizarre.
And he came in wearing the bracelets and he said, have a go. I knew that he was extraordinary.
Lockheed Lounge really very much typifies the type of work that I was doing in 1986. That is to say, with no money, doing what I could with the means that I had available to myself at the time. I'd kind of pictured this completely smooth and streamlined, mercury-like object, when in fact it's bashed together, with a whole lot of little bits of aluminium because it was the only way I could think of doing it. And my work was seen in Europe by one of the very well-known Italian design firms called Capellini. And subsequently they put a few of those things into production. It was really at that moment that I started to kind of live in the world of design.
The Qantas A380 economy seat by Qantas Airways, Marc Newson Limited. Congratulations.
It started off as a brief to design the interior of the entire aircraft. And I guess at the end of the day, that's pretty much what I did. You're talking really everything from the knives and the forks, the economy class seat, the premium economy seat. You're talking about the galleys. I mean, there's literally hundreds of products.
One of the things he always said to me from the time I knew him was that he wanted to go into outer space, and he probably will, because he's already designing, the interiors of space shuttles.
It's really important for me that stuff that I do dates successfully, because I think I like the idea of creating objects that have the potential to become classic. I mean, it's a big word, but, that's my kind of dream.